Hi, it's Loan from Google Tech, and today I'm gonna come back with the 3D printing topic. Nowadays, it's very easy for you to find those models like this in Thingiverse server or from FUSION360. It's online. You can find this model everywhere and make cool things for yourself. But in case you want to make something even cooler, make your project fit better, you can try to modify this model, which is STL file. For example, in this model, I change from this certain round hole into this kind of screw hole to fit the screw head better. You can do that with Toon. And in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to do this with FUSION360. Let's get to the video. The purpose of this tutorial is to show you how to import an STL mesh into FUSION360, convert it into solid body, and do some basic modification. And first of all, what you need to do is turn up the history captures of the FUSION360. Doing such a thing will give you more function in the mesh and surface wash band. So you can right click on the name of the file and choose the do not capture desired history. They're gonna give you a warning, but just go with it, continue. So now there is no history captures. You won't see the history timeline here. And first thing first, we need to import the STL mesh into the file, into the FUSION360. There are two ways to import STL mesh into the FUSION360. First is you go to the mesh wash band. You will see there's an insert mesh right here to import the file. Or you can go to the insert here. You also have insert mesh. Both was fine. Let's go with the insert mesh. And I'm gonna choose the file that I make is the Rhino Hanger is here. Open. So here is the file STL mesh that import into FUSION360. It is still a mesh. As you can see here, it's a mesh. So click on OK. Before convert it into solid, we need to make sure that it has less than 10,000 faces or 10,000 elements in the mesh, because that is the number that FUSION360 can handle. So let's see how many facets or how many elements that we have in our mesh. Right click on the model, go with property here, go to the mesh, and you see the mesh have 236,900 facet count. So what we want is to make it less than 10,000. Okay, so how can we do that? There's a function here in the modify called reduce. What we need to do is reduce it less than 10,000. That's what they said. Right click on the model. You select the model. Go to reduce. Okay. Into the menu here, you can have tolerance, proportion, and phase count. Go with phase count and give it the number that less than 10,000. We want to give at maximum as possible, because if it's less than that, the model become more rough. So I'm gonna put 9,990. Okay, this is the maximum numbers of facets that Fusion can work fine with. Click with OK. Wait for a while. And you see now the mesh is less dense because the number of elements is reduced. So our mesh is good. Let's check the property right now. So our mesh have 9,988 facets. Perfect, it worked. Okay, now the next step we convert into solid so that you can edit it with FUSION360. Go select the mesh, okay, and go to modify if we can convert it to mesh. Here, there are two options, there are two methods actually to convert it. One is faceted and the other is prismatic. Because I'm using the personal, not commercial use of FUSION360, I cannot use the prismatic, so I'm gonna go with faceted and click on OK and wait for Fusion to work. Now you see it changed it to solid. We have a solid model here. In the body, you can see it's a body now, it's not a mesh anymore. And now let's do some basic modification. Let's say this model has a hole already here, but I want to cut, let's say, one hole right here. So let's go to the back of the model, and we need to sketch something. So I'm gonna create a sketch on the back face. It's an example. I'm gonna just make a hole right here. I will not put any important dimension because it's just an example. So I finish with the sketch. Now I want to cut it out of the solid body. We go to extrude, go to cut. Okay. Let's move it in a way that we can see easily. Okay, let's cut. Okay, with a distance, let's say 30. Okay, so you're gonna cut out of the model like this. You can choose to cut it, let's say, from the back surface or the offset from it. So I can cut, like, let's say the offset is 10. Okay, just so that my hole is gonna be from here into outside of the head of the rhino. So okay, good. Okay, so we have a hole now, like that. Perfect. So okay, let's save the model so that we can export it to STL file. I can save it at Rhino. Okay, save. Okay, now I will export it to STL file. So export to STL file. STL file, yeah. Right, no. Export. It's gonna take some time for it to actually export the file because it's a big file. So now FUSION 360 already finished exporting the file to STL file. The final step is just to check to see if we get exactly what we have done here with a new hole and cut with the STL file. I'm gonna check with my slicer, which is FUSA slicer. I'm gonna add the file, it's Rhino V1 open. And here you can see in the back is the original hole and my new hole is already here. You can place on the face and then slide it. Then let's go check if the hole is slicing correctly here. Okay, good. So we have my new hole and this the original one. So this is show you that you can do some basic modification with Fusion 360. And of course, you could see that your model is not as smooth as the original model because we already simplified it less than 10,000 facets. So if you want to keep the original design and keep the original resolution, we have to find another software, which it will be my next tutorial with Blender. Blender is stronger, it's a mesh modeling tool, and you can use it without any limitation about the mesh element. So just let me know right below if you have any question about this tutorial. I will try my best to help. And if you're curious about the next tutorial video with Blender, you can subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. Happy making.